In this video, I will show you how to open the stock quote spreadsheet in SQL offline. The spreadsheet uses AJAX, which requests data from Yahoo Finance. No stock data is saved in the OL file. Now first we'll load the samples and take a look at the JavaScript. Later in the video, I will show you how to create and run your own formulas. Here I have downloaded the OLZ file, which contains three offline documents. Now the matching OLJ file contains the JavaScript. To start the script, we click Enable in the Formula ribbon. Now with formulas enabled, requests are made to Yahoo Finance for each stock symbol. When the request is complete, the data displays. So data is queued up, and when it's sent back, we display it, but we never stop and wait. That's the asynchronous part of AJAX. The New York Stock Exchange file does not even include columns. What happens is data from the first response is reviewed, and a column is added for each property found in the response. Now, so that means the OL file is only a small fraction, about 3% of the CSV file that would contain the data. Now, later in this video, we'll write out a CSV file. But for now, I want to add Twitter, although this is the wrong exchange. All you need to do is insert a row and then type in the symbol. Okay, so that's how to use the stock quote samples. Now let's take a look at how things work. Now, this data all comes from the Yahoo Finance using XML HTTP requests. Again, this is AJAX. Requests are made as each row is evaluated. So as we browse the spreadsheet, requests are made as the row is displayed, and when we get the response back, we update the spreadsheet. So if you double click on the cell, you can see the actual formula. Now, the formula itself simply returns data if it has it and makes a new request if it does not. Here I've clicked Edit Formula in the Formula ribbon and I can see the OLJ JavaScript editor. Now, the most important part is the Microsoft.xml HTTP object, which is the heart of AJAX. Browsers have this object built in, but for SQL offline, you can use ActiveX object to create it here. A URL is formed from the stock symbol for your row and a request sent. When the request is complete, the ready state change function is called, and we can save the stock data. So the more you browse, the more stock data is saved. Now AJAX is well documented, so I won't go into detail here. But the best way to see what's going on is to step through a script debugger. Here in the debugger, we can see the properties provided in the XML response. Now if you have Visual Studio installed, all you need to do is set a breakpoint in the formula editor. Please see Product Help for more information on debugging formulas. Now, the data link here is to a CSV file, so if we write data, we create a CSV file that you can open in Excel. At the bottom of the screen in the status bar, you can see that there are a lot of requests pending. As you might have guessed, there are some side effects to the asynchronous requests. What happens is the first time we write data to the CSV file, it causes all of the requests for the entire spreadsheet to queue up. So if we look at the data in Excel, we can see that only the rows at the top, the ones that we have already browsed, have data complete. Now there's no magic here, we need to wait. Now I'll fast forward this for the video, but this took about 15 minutes to get all of the requests back. After all the requests are complete, I can write the CSV file again. Now you can stop and start the OLJ formula to refresh the stock data, but for now there will be no additional requests because all stock data is now in memory. Specifically, it's being stored in a JavaScript array. Now I'll load Excel, and this time we can see the data for all the rows. To finish this video, I want to create some formulas from scratch. AJAX is familiar to web developers, but still a bit tricky. So in the Formulas ribbon, you can select either JavaScript or Basic. I'm going to leave it as JavaScript. You click the Column button, and a column formula is created, which simply returns value string. The value that's returned is what displays in the spreadsheet. Now, I can create a cell formula, which is just a formula for one cell, and I'm going to list functions here to return the date. And when I close this dialog box, it returns whatever the current date is and time. The next thing I'll do is select the remainder of the spreadsheet and click Global. And what we'll do is we'll make a small multiplication table because I'm multiplying the row times the column. So that's how easy it is to create JavaScript formulas in SQL offline. Finally, I want to create a JS file. SQL Offline is a script host, so you can edit and run JS and VBS files. Even if you don't use SQL Offline to work with the database, you might find it useful to edit and test Windows JScript and Visual Basic Script files. In the script editor, you can press a period to activate smart editing for objects like Windows Script Host or the file system object. You can click Functions in the Objects drop-down to list functions and JavaScript native objects like math, string, and date. And then when you're ready, click Run, and it will run the script. I need some parens here for the script engine. So that's how to create and test a simple JS file. I'll save the file and exit SQL offline. In a Windows Explorer, this time I'll run the JS file using Microsoft Windows Script Host. So all of this is familiar for web developers and system admins, but even if you've never worked with scripts, I hope you find it surprisingly easy to begin using JavaScript as a spreadsheet formula language. And that completes this video. For tutorials and additional samples, please visit Product Help, and thank you for watching.